So, I got a question for you. Are you teaching math right? Well, that is a huge question and could mean so many different things. Yet, I get asked it a lot. I'm Christina Tonnevold, the recovering traditionalist, and today I'm going to start a little mini series about what it means to teach math right. And kind of the three big areas that when people ask me that question, they're really wondering about. This week, we're going to start off on a soapbox I tend to get up on a lot. It's whether or not we should teach conceptually or procedurally. So first, let's talk about what does it mean to teach math conceptually and what does it mean to teach math procedurally? Now again, even that is a huge question, and so I'm going to summarize it in a way that some people may say is way too simple. But just for our case here, I want to talk about the two kind of distinct differences between teaching conceptually and teaching procedurally. Procedurally was basically the way that I grew up having math taught to me. It was taught as a set of rules and procedures that I was supposed to memorize and apply on problems that usually had no context to them. It was, you know, the typical kind of traditional math book where it was a sheet of 50 pages in the book, or maybe it was a worksheet. Usually it was out of the book back when I was doing it. And it was just bare problems, and it was just repetition after repetition to see, could you get all 50 some problems done correctly? It wasn't about how you did it. It was all about whether or not you got the answer correct. So oftentimes when people are talking about teaching math procedurally, that's the vision they have in mind, is when we focus on procedures and getting kids to practice, and that we're focusing on the answer. Did they get the answer correct? The flip side of that is when we're talking about teaching math conceptually. And again, people may have a more in-depth version of this, but to me, conceptually teaching is a focus on how kids are doing it. So typically it's focused on helping them understand why we're doing those procedures, and not so much even a focus on a specific procedure. Traditionally, a procedural type of mathematics is there's one way to do it. Conceptually teaching mathematics is letting the kids do it in a way that makes sense to them, and then looking at other ways that kids did it. Often they are given mathematics in a contextual situation, so where it's put in real life terms, or it's even a problem that's given to kids with no predetermined path. Like it's a what's often called a non-routine problem. There's no one set way to solve it. It could be approached in lots of different ways, and you're really helping kids to see how mathematics can help them solve a real life non-routine type of problem. Now, what has happened in the past is that in education, we tend to go all in on something. So for a while, it was all about skill and drill and just teaching the procedures and really focused on procedural thinking. And not procedural thinking, just procedural doing, really, just doing the math. It didn't matter how you, it sometimes for certain teachers, it mattered how you did it, but the real focus was on getting the end result. And then there were realizing, okay, that's not working for some of our kids and maybe even a majority of our kids. So we swing the complete other way, and it becomes all about letting kids just discover mathematics and play and talk about how they're thinking about math without a focus on still getting to an answer. And anytime that we go all in on something, it's often not the best. Because I am a firm believer in balance, and in mathematics, kids need balance as well. If you aren't familiar with our whole history of math education, there's a great book, I always forget this, back behind me here, by Matt Larson, all about balancing the equation. And he talks about the history of how we've had these pendulum swings and how it really needs to stop. And I am a firm supporter of that idea. Kids need both. Kids need to develop that conceptual understanding and play with math and see how it relates to their life and see that, man, if I don't get it this way, it's okay. I understand it this way. But they also do need to know that sometimes there is one right answer. And sometimes we just need to practice, because anything in life, we get better at it if we practice. So if we're going all in on conceptual understanding for kids, we're leaving off that ability to practice that stuff that they have learned. We understand it better and we do better if we continually practice. If we go all in with procedural understanding, we come away with kids like me, who I thought I was good at math, but I was really only good at following steps and procedures. When I had a real life math problem, I was horrible at it, and I had no thinking skills. I would see a problem, and if I didn't instantly know how to solve it, I would shut down because I wasn't sure how to approach it. I couldn't remember the steps I was supposed to take. Neither one of those are good. It doesn't bring a well-rounded understanding of mathematics for our students. We need to balance our instruction. So if you want to make sure you're teaching math right, the first thing that I would recommend is balance your instruction. And I'm not saying it's an easy thing. It's a hard line to know when you've crossed it. When am I spending too much time focusing on procedures? When have I let them play enough and now it's time to move on and get them to practice? It's not an easy feat, and I can't tell you that, you know, once you do this few activities, then it's time to just start practicing. It depends upon your kids. It depends upon their experiences. Sometimes it even depends upon the models that you're using and the visuals that kids have. Sometimes that can make it easier and faster for them to move on into that procedural practice stage. You've just got to know that you've got to have a balance of both and be cautious with your teaching. If you feel like you're swaying too far one way or too far the other way, think about how you can bring in the other thing. And I'll tell you, the one thing that makes it even harder is that your curriculums tend to be one way or the other. There's not a whole lot that are down the middle. You've either got a really procedural type curriculum or you've got a conceptual type curriculum. Know which one yours is, and just know you've got to bring in others. People ask me all the time, what's the best curriculum? There isn't one, because they're all lacking in some way. Definitely there are people out there working to change that and starting to move in that direction. But at the time of this recording, there's not ones that I can say, these do a great job of it. All curriculums are going to have their issue, but just know which side are they on and know that you've got to bring some of the others in. And just reflect upon your own teaching, no matter what curriculum you're using, are you doing a balance of both for your students? All right, I hope that this helped you build your math mind a little bit more about what the right way to teach math is. And I hope it helps you go out there and build the math minds of your students. Don't forget, check out Matt's book back there, Balancing the Equation. It's a wonderful read. Have a great day.